Hi there.
So today I'm working with the CG50 Casio graphing calculator. It's our color graphing calculator. And I am going to be showing you two things: how to enter numbers in scientific notation, both just to use them in calculations, but also how you can use them to set up a scale for an axis. And so to do that, the reason that you might want to do that is if you're talking with very, very large numbers. And so I have an activity which I've included in the description below, that deals with the Earth's revolution. And we're also gonna go into the conics menu over here on the left, if you look, just to show you how you can enter the conics there. So this activity is basically about the Earth's revolution and how it follows Kepler's first law of planetary motion, that the orbit is actually elliptical. So students are given some information, and you'll notice that it's talking about the revolution, which is our year, 365.26 days. But it talks about very, very large numbers, 147 million kilometers and 152 million kilometers, which is the distance from the Earth to the Sun at its closest and farthest points. So our solstice, if you think about that. So students have to work with this, and the first thing they're asked to do is, can you set up an axis? Because obviously we can't do, you know, 1 through 10 or negative 10 to 10, because it's not going to fit these very large numbers. And you also don't want those very large numbers. So first thing they have to do is figure out, what's a good scale? How can I think about where I need to have these numbers? The Sun is the foci of the ellipse, that type of thing. So, and I'm just going to scroll through here and kind of show you that this is talking about scientific notation. Now, it's a little bit different now because the calculator's been updated. And I just want to go into, if you're just going to work with scientific numbers and calculations, you would do that in the Run Matrix menu. So you'll see that that's highlighted here. I'm going to hit Execute to come in. And now I just want to show you how you enter scientific notation. So 147 million is really quite far, right? And we're going to add these two together. What's the largest distance that we have if this is the sum, because it's both of them on one end? So that's what's happening here. They're adding. And so when I want to enter the number scientifically, I enter the 1.47 and I've moved my decimal 8 places. So that's 10 to the 8th. And so you'll notice down here next to the negative sign and next to the period is this scientific notation button. In here it said E, but we're going to use this. And so watch what happens. It puts the 10 in there, and then all you have to do is enter, you know, your place value. So for us it's 8 in this case. And then now we're just going to add. So this is now reading this as scientific, and so we're going to add 1.52. And again, you hit that button to get the times 10 and put in your exponent for the power of 10. And then when you hit execute, it's going to add them. So there. So notice that the answer is not in scientific notation. It gives us the actual numerical value, but we could convert it. And now it says, okay, so here you have this answer divided by 2. So let's do that, divide by 2. And now we have our scale. We want 1.495 on either side of our axes, which would be at the 0. So that's how we're figuring that out. Now I'm going to hit exit to get out of this, and I'm going to go back into my menu, and we're going to go down to the conics, because we're going to be graphing the elliptical path of the Earth. So I'm going to use that in the conic graph. So I want to go into that menu. So I'm going to scroll down here, or I could have hit the 9. And when I hit execute, you'll see here's the equations of my different graphs. So here's the parabolas, lots of different ways. And we're just going to keep scrolling. Then you see the circle equation, and that's a couple different ways as well. So depending on which form of the equation you're working with. And we're going to go into the ellipse right here. So there's only one ellipse. But before I do that, I want to make sure I've set up my window, my view window. So I'm going to go into my view window. So F3. And so notice our numbers are so large, this view window is not going to work for us. And we just calculated this. So I really want to go from -1.495. And I'm going to use my scientific notation button again and put in my 8. So I can use that even in when I'm setting up windows. And when I hit execute, it brings me down to the next line. And then we're going to do the same thing. We want positive. hit that button, put in your exponential value, hit execute. We probably want our scale to be, I don't know, I'm just going to make up a number here. And then, whoops, shift, window, let's go back to that. So we're going to do the same thing for our X and Y min. We're going to enter it. So entering scientific notation values is relatively easy. You're just using this button down here. You hit it. That gives you your times 10. And then you simply enter whatever the exponent value is that you're using for your number. So I'm going to do it one more time, and let's change the scale here. All right, so we've set up my window. I'm going to hit execute, and or exit rather, and we're going to go back in and to graph our conics. So here we are back at the conics, and we're actually ready to enter our numerical values. So this is the equation for an ellipse, and we're working with the Earth orbits and the numbers that they've calculated. So in the activity, you'll see that they do a lot of calculations. They use the Pythagorean theorem to try to really figure out where the foci are and the endpoints. Then they're going to enter their distances here, right? And we're at the origin. The activity says, you know, you're at the origin. So we're not going to have an H and K, but we do have an A and B value, which are the distances, the closest distance and the furthest distance from the sun on this elliptical path. And they are actually have very specific names. The close distance is the perihelion, and the far distance is the aphelion. And so they're given those distances. And so those are the distances we're going to use. But again, large numbers, we want to be able to enter scientific notation. And that is also possible even when you're working with equations. So we highlighted the equation we want. We hit execute. So notice this is just to fill in the numbers that you have to create the conic. And so we have the A value, which is going to be, let's just kind of scare it down here, the furthest distance from. So notice the distances are really close. And this is going to come into play in what your ellipse and how your scale impacts what the actual path looks like. So it's 1.495 and 1.4947, so very, very close to each other. So let's put them in, and we're going to enter them just as we would with normal scientific. You hit that button to get the 10, and then hit the power, and then when you hit execute, it enters it. And so now we have 1.4947, hit the power of 10, put in your exponent, and we know that we're at the origin, so we don't have any values for H or K. It's centered at the origin. And so now we're ready to draw. So when you hit F6, which is underneath the draw, you're going to see this elliptical path, and you can hit the trace, shift trace, and you can see that there's that first distance. And if we kind of follow along, there's my, well, it's a little hard to see the number, but that's the other distance. And they're so close to each other. Let's do this one. We can see a little better. They're so close to each other, but because of the scale we're using, so this scale is, it makes this look very elliptical. But if they're that close to each other, it should actually be more kind of circular, even though it's still an ellipse. Remember, an ellipse is just a special circle. So how could we make this be more realistic to what the actual path is? Because right now it looks incredibly elliptical, more, I don't know what the word is, but so how can we do that? Well, we're going to go back into our view window and square it up so that the distances are more squared. So right now we don't have a good square model here. So notice that there is an option under view window for square. So when I hit F5, which is what the square is above, it's asking what's your base, and so we're going to say y is our base. And so notice it changed the y value to show less. So let's hit execute, and now let's draw it again, and now you'll see values are exactly the same. If we hit trace, we still have the same values that we had before, except now because our scale is a little bit more squared, we're actually seeing a more realistic visual of what the orbit looks like because we have squared up the thing. So it's still ellipse. It's not exactly the equidistant all the way around, right? Which would make it a complete circle, but it's still very much closer to a circle versus a wider ellipse or a more squished ellipse, elongated. That's the word I'm looking here at this thing. So that's how you work with scientific notation and the conic graph. We just looked at an ellipse, so we'll look at more later, but have fun exploring that.